Today we will be discussing about the particle in one dimension infinitely deep potential well. Now let us suppose that a particle is restricted to move in one dimension between two points such that 0 is less than x, 0 is less than or equal to x, is less than or equal to a. This may be understood by imagining absolutely impenetrable walls at x equal to 0 and x equal to a, so that the particle will be reflected at x equal to 0 and x equal to a. The potential function in this case, as shown in this figure, may be defined as Vx is equal to infinity for x less than 0 and x greater than a, and this is equal to 0 for 0 is less than x is less than a. According to above conditions, the probability of finding the particle at x equal to 0 and at x equal to a is equal to 0, so that we can write psi 0 is equal to psi a, this is equal to 0, and psi x is equal to finite for 0 is less than x is less than a. Now the equation of motion for the particle for the region 0 is less than x is less than a, this may be written as del 2 psi upon del x square plus 2m upon h cross square e psi, this equal to 0. Psi is equal to, the general solution of this equation may be written as psi x is equal to a sin kx plus b cos kx, where k is equal to under root 2m e upon h cross. Now using boundary condition psi x equal to 0 when x equal to 0, so we get from, if we put this boundary condition in this equation, we get b is equal to 0. Now substituting this value, we get psi x is equal to a sin kx. Using boundary conditions, psi x is equal to 0 for x is equal to a, we get a sin k a is equal to 0, yeah, sin k a is equal to 0, because a cannot be equal to 0, so k a is equal to n plus 1 pi, where n is an integer equal to or greater than 0 is less than equal to n is less than equal to infinity. Here we have not used the form n pi, because when n is equal to 0, psi is equal to 0 everywhere, which indicates that the particle does not exist in the well anywhere. This is a trivial solution. Thus the proper solution of this equation will be psi x is equal to a sin n plus 1 pi x equal to 0, and substituting the value of k, we get n plus 1 pi upon a is equal to under root 2 m e upon h cross, so that the energy or eigen values are given by En is equal to pi square h cross square upon 2m a square n plus 1 ka whole square, where n is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. Now it is clear that inside the an infinitely deep potential well, the particle can have only certain values of energy given by equation 9. The assembly of energy eigen of a particle is called its energy spectrum. Thus the energy spectrum in an infinitely deep potential well is discrete, while the energy spectrum of free particle without boundaries is continuous. The least energy state that has no node except at the boundaries x equal to 0 and x equal to a. This is called the ground state. The state corresponding to n is equal to 1 has one node and is called first excited state. The state corresponding to n is equal to 2, this is called the second excited state, and so on. Now, how to normalize the wave function? According to the condition of normalization, a wave function is normalized if 0 to a sin x square dx is equal to 1. Now, putting the value of sin x, we can say that a square 0 to a sin square n plus 1 pi a x dx is equal to 0. Now, upon solving this equation, we can say that a square into small a upon 2 is equal to 1, or capital A is equal to under root 2 upon a. Thus, the normalized wave function is given by psi n is equal to under root 2 upon a sin n plus 1 pi upon a x. That's it.